How do you keep it fresh?
I don't know.
Seriously.
I think every once in a while we do these episodes that end up being like sort of backstory about the characters, you know, and that I don't know if it's a function of subconsciously like, let's change it up a little bit and go to Pam's wedding or whatever. But I think that helps a lot and sort of gets us out of the mission of the week temptation. So, and those are also fun to write. And I think each cast member, when they get a script like, hey, we're going to go spend time with Cheryl or whoever, they really like that. So, but other than that, I don't know.
Has there been any difference to how you approach writing for it now than how you did when you first started?
I don't smoke anymore.
Cigarettes?
Yeah, like cigarettes. Yeah, I used to be a big tobacco user and I quit like 3 seasons ago, so I don't do that anymore. But it used to be, just pounding tobacco and staying up for days at a time. But now I don't do that and I write in the daytime.
Will we ever find out Archer's father?
Yeah, yeah, okay. but probably not until the very last episode, so okay. I don't know when that's going to be. I was thinking about that on the flight out here. Hopefully it's going to be a long way off.
Mm-hmm. Fingers crossed.
Yeah.
Do you have an ending in mind, or are you just going to keep dragging us out until they cancel it?
There's a nice way to say that. I have given it some thought, like what the last episode would look like. It's not anytime soon, I hope. So yeah, I'll just keep dragging it out until they say that's it, nobody's watching anymore. It's just you yelling in an empty room. I think we've got some time before we get to the last episode and Archer accidentally kills his father, or whatever happens.
Anything this season as obscure as Michael Graves from Shazam.
That's going to be hard to top. We don't have anything that obscure yet, but I'm writing episode 3, so we're still early on. We still have time to get really obscure. But he turned out to be a lovely, lovely man, and keeps in touch and sends us emails and Shazam posters.
Nice. Do you have a favorite character to write for?
You know, they're all of them. It sounds dumb, but each one like makes me laugh in their own way. And I really like those like origin story episodes because you can dig in a little deeper about who they are. They're all different, but all enjoyable to write for. There's really Ray's the crappiest one.
I have a question. It's kind of a personal thing for me, but what's it like to have a job that doesn't really require you to have to wear pants, and how do I get one?
You can just stop wearing pants to work, and then like I'm sure like the ACLU would step in and be like, you can't make this guy wear pants. It's pretty great. Like, this is really dressed up for me. It's usually t-shirt, shorts, flip-flops, and our office is very, very casual, you know. People bring their dogs in there. One girl has a pet rat, a giant rat that she brings in lieu of a dog. I feel really lucky have to wear pants.
When you guys get together at conventions like this, do you get to do any like bonding with all of the cast members?
Yeah.
Anything special?
FX always puts on a lovely dinner for us and everybody drinks a bunch of wine and makes fun of each other. This is the only time really when we're all together. And this year, extra special, Jessica Walter's here, which she, you know, normally doesn't like to schlep all the way out here. And Judy's always off doing a movie. So it's really great to have everybody here because they're all really great to hang out with. They're a sharp bunch of mostly mean-spirited comedy.